So we have Aero on the left side, and he is going to be running that Lickitung, the Carbink, Gligar, Chargebug, Skarmory, and Poliwrath, and I'll go. And he has placed top 16 at NAIC, was a Fort Wayne regional finalist, and the Arlington regional top 8.
And he is one of the most seasoned trainers out there. He has a ton of championship series experience, and he is extremely creative with his team compositions. Once again, he is bringing the Carbink and that Steel Wing Skarmory. He said sometimes it is a little bit alignment oriented, but I feel like there hasn't been much Lantern at all. There's just been Chargebug has replaced it. So as long as you avoid the Registeel, that Skarmory could be quite strong. And on the other side, Toonbug, he has a ton of accomplishments. He has been a regional champion. He has been in multiple top 16s, multiple top cuts. He is one of the best trainers in North America, and he always seems to have a signature core breaker, and this time it is the Skeledirge. I'm not sure how strong the Skeledirge is in this meta, so it's a good thing he brought those timeless Pokemon of the Registeel, Cresselia, and Altaria.
Yeah, he's backed this Skeledirge up with quite some strong, even just strong neutral picks in this meta. And, you know, Butters, we haven't sampled too much of Skeledirge, but while we saw it in action, this is a triple threat. It's got a fantastic fast move. It's got great coverage moves here. If Duma can find the angle, it's all about finding the angle with the Skeledirge, right? If you find the right angle, your opponent cannot do anything.
Oh,
and it looks like we're going into the battle here, and we've got the Skeledirge from Toonbug catching Arrow's Chargebug in the lead here, and immediately Arrow is in trouble here, but it looks like his backline is prepped to potentially handle a Skeledirge.
And it looks like Doombug's backline is weak to Poliwrath, so Doombug is actually staying in to this matchup against the Poliwrath. Remember, this is a ghost type, so you're double resisting the counters, but you will take super effective from the Scald. We saw him call an Icy Wind bait before. Can he call it two times in a row? No! Gets the Icy Wind bait into Doombug and picks up the first Protect Shield.
Yep, and Doombug respecting it right here, maybe thinking it's a little bit too early. However, he is gonna pace to another Disarming Voice. If your Arrow, do you use the Protect Shield again? You've already debuffed your opponent, and it looks like he is gonna commit the second Protect Shield here. Cannot let the Skeledirge see the Chargebug, and it looks like we might go straight into the Scald here. And it's up to Doombug here. Do you invest your second shield here in the favor of potentially knocking out Poliwrath? And he does. And is there going to be a debuff here? There's a second debuff. And although the Skeledirge is going to win and get to the Disarming Voice, Doombug chooses to go for the Shadow Ball instead. Now, I mean, this is going to be a hard-hitting neutral stab Shadow Ball, but it is double debuffed. It does not take out the Poliwrath, and we see the instant switch.
And Poliwrath able to two shield. Arrow has been using this strategy so many times in San Antonio to double Protect Shield that Poliwrath. It plays to his favor once again, and then he leaves a lasting debuff on the Scald and almost gets to the Icy Wind, but now this Whiscash is at about 35% health, and it's one stage debuffed, and it's coming into the Chargebug here. Arrow is bringing in the Chargebug instead of the Lickitung to actually soak this energy, and unfortunately for Arrow, there is a Registeel in the back for Doombug, so that Lickitung is not going to like this see that backline matchup.
Yeah, and I think this is really unfortunate for Arrow. I think what he's hoping to do right here is maybe catch the Skeledirge a little bit off with the switch timer. Oh no, he's gonna go straight into the Lickitung. He's preparing to go into it. Now, the problem is we haven't seen the Registeel yet, and the Registeel is gonna have a fairly easy time getting through both of Arrow's Pokemon here. Let's see if he has a plan for this. We do see the Lickitung come out in favor of the Skeledirge. It is locked in for just a little bit, but there is the surprise right there. Registeel comes out to play here. Arrow's shaking his head. I mean, there is still a little bit of a chance, Butters, that the Chargebug can come out of the follow-up Registeel matchup with a Discharge, maybe? But this is going to be very, very tough here. It's going to be all up to this Chargebug, and it's going to be up to the Lickitung here to potentially set things up for maybe, I don't know, maybe a farm down or so.
The problem is Skeledirge banked a Shadow Ball, and I believe Skeledirge will win charge attack priority against that Chargebug. So even if Chargebug comes out with an attack, the Skeledirge is just waiting, and now this Lickitung is going to be battling back against this Registeel. How many times this turn tournament have we seen Doombug with a Registeel into Lickitung. Lickitung is number one in usage in day number one and day number two, and Doombug brought the exact counter to it and is almost about to lock on down. Arrow might be very close to his timer here, but he's also very close to losing this game number one.
Yeah, this is very unfortunate. He has forced the swap here. Now, Chargebug is going to resist both moves out of the Registeel, but it still does quite a bit of damage, and you do need to have enough health to survive the Incinerate. And now Skeletor Dirge, it doesn't matter. It's coming in with a disarming voice, and it's going to take out this Chargebug. And I think, Butters, this is going to be all that she wrote, because the Lickitung only has a Body Slam here. Skeletor Dirge does not care about Body Slam. It only cares about the licks, and you're not going to be able to get that many licks in before the Lickitung faints.
And Doombug has won 13 straight games to start this grand finals. But remember, he is on the loser's side of this bracket. So even if he beats Arrow in this series, that will reset the bracket, and then he'll have another chance in the grand finals to become the champion. But what an incredible run from losing the first game in first match in day number one to 13 straight wins in day number two. Absolutely incredible.
Yeah, and I think from a momentum standpoint, this is about as high as you can get right here, and great planning from Doombug right there. Stayed in the matchup, invested two of the shields here. We've seen somewhat, we've seen rarely today, people are investing two shields in their Pokemon, but in this case, he escapes with the Skeletor Dirge, gets it into a safe position here, and then comes back in to take out the only potential counter for Registeel in that Poliwrath. So great job on Doombug's side.
And game number two, it's on its way. It's Chargebug into Registeel. Registeel instantly swaps into Wishcast. Do you bring out the Poliwrath? There it is. Do you go for a Cheeky Scald? No, going for the Mud Bomb. But I want to point out, a lot of these trainers have been throwing the Mud Bomb first and then throwing the Scald. It's really unpredictable when these top trainers will throw the debuff attack.
Yeah, and for sure, Mud Bomb with a recent buff, right, still does quite a chunk of damage. It's up to Arrow here to control this matchup. But I think Doombug, I think you're right. Doombug might follow up with another Scald here. Let's see if he wants to go for the debuff or if he's happy with just going for the double Mud Bomb. Looks like it is going to be the double Mud Bomb. Arrow knows that he is going to survive this no matter what the move is, but you're probably going to see another Mud Bomb come out of Doombug. You might have to invest a Protect Shield here just to get through this, but it's really up to Arrow to make that decision.
Yeah, and that's enough to get the knockout. So Arrow puts up the Protect Shield, and the trouble is you're going to have to give a Protect Shield back, because if you come in with Gligar, two Wing Attack down, you're probably going to want a Protect Shield. No, comes in with the Registeel, but this is going to be so tough. You're going to have to lock on down, or maybe you soak this energy into the Registeel, and then you swap into the Gligar to get the Wing Attack down. Let's see if that's what Doombug is going for. No, he's going to try for the lock on down.
And Scald does so much damage here. There's going to be another Scald coming to Doombug's way. He's going to opt not to shield this one. I think his goal is to soak this up and rely on the Gligar to be able to sweep here. He is frantically going for the switch here, and he's going to be able to farm this down. I think Arrow is still in a tough position here, because the Chargebug isn't going to be able to do that much. Maybe an extended matchup, these X-Scissors will add up, but Doombug has invested in both shields here, and he is going to put all of his trust into this Gligar.
Two things. Arrow went in straight away. You don't want to wait your switch timer there, because that is just giving the advantage to your opponent that just swapped. So he went in straight away. Number two, Doombug almost has a Focus Blast or Zap Cannon banked. So if he can use that down the stretch against this Chargebug, there is still play for Doombug here, but he has to get all the way through this Lickitung. Now it is at Protect Shield parity. This looks like an Aerial Ace bait here, and an instant no Protect Shield from Arrow. So you're gonna have to double Aerial Ace to knock out this Lickitung.
Yeah, and Arrow being really smart here, I think he knows that there is a potential move on the Registeel. He knows that it does a little bit under half on Chargebug, and he needs to preserve or mold the game situation into a way that he can get this Chargebug set up for success here. I mean, it would not shock me if he decides to take the move here no matter what it is, and he does. He no-shields the dig here because he is preparing to have the Registeel come in, and he needs to be able to answer it as quickly as he can.
And this X-Scissor is not enough. You're going to need the double X-Scissor here, because this is not a Shadow Gligar. I don't think you can Volt Switch down. And as you're getting to that double X-Scissor, you're getting in range of getting knocked out by the Zap Cannon or Focus Blast. Here comes the X-Scissor. Doombug needs to endure. If he doesn't endure to throw the Aerial Ace, I think it's a wrap for him in this game. Can he hold on? No, it's a knockout, and I think that's it for Doombug. Doombug is just going to get Volt Switch down, and Arrow
ties up the series and ruins the win streak of Doonbug, finally giving him a loss.
And what an ending right there. No matter what, Registeel can't come in and get out of that situation. I mean, that was, I think that was a very risky play from Doonbug here without too much knowledge of Arrow's lineup here. Put it all onto this Gligar, even if you're up 2-1 shields. It just wasn't enough in the very end.
Yeah, I mean, you had maybe a slight chance if you could somehow get that Protect Shield with the Aero Ace in the end, but you needed to endure on that Ixazor. As we see the replay here, you throw the dig. And the important part here is you need to get this Charger Bug in range of Zap Cannon or Focus Blast to have a chance of winning. They do the exact same amount of damage. And look, it's almost, this is so close, because you saw how much the last Ixazor did. If he was able to hold on with one health, he might have been able to secure that game, but he got knocked out. And we are in game number 3. It's gonna be Wizcatch versus Lickitung in the lead. And remember, you take double super effective from Power Whip. The Scald is just gonna be coming out to try to get the debuff, but also, it's your most energy effective move. It's better than Mud Bomb, so you're throwing it no matter what.
Yeah, and I think Arrow's happy to see, let's see if the debuff connects. It does not, and I think Arrow's happy to see this Wizcatch in the lead here, because he's got a Gligar hidden in the back in preparation for Registeel. Arrow really changing up his lineup here, and he's gonna go for the Body Slam bait.
And that is huge, because now you're going to be able to outpace and let this Scald go and get to a Power Whip. So you probably can pick up 2 Protect Shields here, unless you want to try to swap into that Registeel. But Arrow has said Gligar is so strong, and Gligar is on his team. There's 2 Registeel answers in the back for Arrow. This is looking terrible for Doombug here. Can you secure the knockout? You are debuffed, so you don't secure the knockout here. But can Wizcatch get to the next Scald? Yes, does get to the next Scald. So does force a Protect Shield. No, actually, the Lickitung just goes down here, and Arrow is just happy with his Protect Shield advantage.
Yeah, and I like how Arrow has played this, because he's going to come in here with this Gligar, get a bunch of energy. The way that he has built his team has changed so much, and now seeing the Doombug's Gligar come in, he now can sense that there is possibly a Registeel in the back here. So protecting this Poliwrath here, I think Arrow's got to be pretty happy with how this match is unfolding so far.
He should be very happy, because he has 2 really good answers for Registeel in the back, and Registeel is laying there awaiting. And that has been the strongest Pokemon for Doombug this entire run, but Arrow has sniffed that out and has the double counters for it, and really has stifled Doombug's entire momentum here. I felt like Doombug had everything going for him, and suddenly Arrow just has the edge, not only in this game, but in the series right now.
Yeah, and we're gonna see a crucial moment here. Arrow is going to invest the Protect Shield. I mean, as a reminder, if this Gligar goes down, it's Poliwrath versus Registeel, and now we have Registeel coming in, and it's going to be met by Poliwrath here. I mean, Poliwrath is going to have a pretty clear way to victory here, because the only thing that Poliwrath needs to do is shield this charged attack, doesn't matter what it is, and it is going to be the Zap Cannon coming out. I mean, is Doombug going to get maybe a helpful debuff here? And we do see that attack fell, but Poliwrath gets a chance to fight right back, and Scald still does quite a bit of damage.
And going for the Scald here, and you're almost at the double Scald. Let's see if it does get Protect Shielded by Doombug. Letting it go, this should not knock out because of that debuff, and Registeel does hold on here. So you can get to the double Zap Cannon no matter what. Looks like it's just going to be the Ice Wind, and he actually, no Protect Shields this. So I actually think the Registeel can get to the Zap Cannon to force the knockout into this Poliwrath, or force the, yes, I believe it actually will get really close to knocking out. And suddenly, is Doombug back in this game because of letting that Icy Wind go? But no, there's just not enough health.
Poliwrath survives it. But here's the problem. You're giving farm to Doombug, but I don't know. Counter versus, I think you're going to have a wing attack.
You just have to get to the wing attack.
And Arrow is able to clutch it out.
Yeah, you didn't have enough health in the end on the Gligar. You had that Protect Shield remaining to Protect Shield that Aerial Ace, but you just didn't have enough left in terms of health. But Doombug made that quite close, but Arrow is one game away from securing his first ever regional championships. And I feel like he has taken all the momentum in this series. He is running counters for that Registeel. He is running Poliwrath and Shadow Gligar. If you're Doombug, how are you even countering that here?
And let's see the crucial moment here towards the very end. You know, actually, Butters, I thought that had the Registeel survived against the Poliwrath, I mean, it actually gave Arrow a window to come in and start wing attacking down this Registeel. Registeel could not have reached another move in time, but here's a crucial play right here, able to get a little bit of chip damage off. Doonbug was energy dry on the Gligar, and Arrow is able just to come in one wing attack away from victory from Doonbug. That would have swung everything back into his momentum.
And are we gonna see the Cresselia? Doonbug has made so many awesome plays with Cresselia, with Cash Core, having Registeel as well. Can he pull off one more victory to stay alive in this tournament? And it's gonna be Gligar versus Gligar. In the backline, matchups are definitely gonna matter, because if you can align that Registeel into Lickitung, it's gonna look really good for Doonbug. This is crucial though, Mark. Arrow does win charge attack priority on Gligar.
Yeah, and I think Doonbug's gonna be well aware of this thing. He's running ABA flyers because he's really anticipating a little bit of ushering for his Registeel here. I mean, and looking at the backline for Arrow, we have seen Chargebug put up quite a good fight up against Registeel. I mean, if alignment does happen, though, I would still say that it's going to come down to this Altaria versus Lickitung matchup. And here, Arrow is going to fire off the Arrow Lace here, and Doonbug is going to let this one go. That means that Doonbug's Gligar will not reach the next charge move, but it is up to Arrow whether he wants to use a shield or not, and he does. He's going to use this Gligar as potential insurance against Registeel down the road.
That's smart, because you don't know if you guarantee the alignment just by going for the wing attack down. It might have been simultaneous, but Doonbug might have had more stat product and actually win that zero protect shield situation. So Arrow just wants to make sure he has the alignment, but now Doonbug does have double protect shield Altaria, which looks pretty good against the backline. Here's the Lickitung to bait out the Registeel. Looks like Doonbug is gonna gather some energy and then probably soak the body slam. No, doesn't soak the body slam, actually stays in with the Altaria.
Yeah, he's gonna stay in with Altaria. I think he senses that Arrow wants the Registeel to come out, so it looks like he's trying to see. Oh, there he goes, trying to banking. He was gathering some energy right there. Now the Registeel is going to come in, and Doonbug has to be very careful. He has both his protect shields here, so he could maneuver the situation to where he comes out with a charge move. However, he doesn't know what the third Pokemon is, and you know, looking at that Chargebug in the back line, Butters, we do know that it survives any one charge move, right? So a lot of flexibility. You cannot let your Pokemon get too low here, because they're both going to take neutral Volt Switch damage, and this is where I think Arrow is kind of headed with this match.
And the Focus Vest lands, but doesn't knock out the Lickitung. And to that point, you can't let this Registeel get too low, because we have seen Registeel in the back be too clunky to finish off teams. All of these Pokemon, the Gligar has a little health. Even that little health Gligar, look, can come in and get a charge attack out of this Registeel, a Focus Blast out of this Registeel. So soaking all of this energy at, what, 5% health, just because Registeel can't really fast attack anything down. So it's all gonna come down the charge bug for Arrow here.
Yeah, and this is gonna be very dangerous. You are gonna need at minimum, I think, four charge moves, two to break shields and two to take out either Altaria or Registeel. The first charge move is gonna come out. Hopefully for Arrow, this Zap Cannon does not debuff, but let's see if it is in Doombug's favor. It is gonna be attack fall right here. And now we're gonna be in a much tougher hill to climb up here. Altaria still has the charge move banked up as well as two shields. And here comes Altaria to try to finish things off.
And here comes the sky attack, and it's let go by Arrow. Arrow thinks that he can't get the Volt Switch down and get enough onto the Registeel, so he lets his Chargebug go, and suddenly we have a tied series in this Grand Finals. It is 2-2 between Arrow and Doonbug.
Yeah, we're going to an explosive game five. I mean, and if anything, for these two trainers, with how their day has gone, with how dominant that they have been on either side of the bracket, I think it's only fitting, Butters, that we are going to be forced to go to a game five, and we might have more matches the way after this too.
Yeah, if Doonbug can secure victory here, he will reset the Grand Finals bracket, and then these two trainers will go at it once again. And the stubbornness of Doonbug. Doonbug has been as stubborn as Registeel, because he keeps bringing it, even though Arrow keeps showing so many counters to it. This game, there weren't those counters to Registeel, and it was great in the back line. So he was able to secure the victory with those timeless two Pokemon of Altaria and Registeel.
Yeah, and I like the adjustment there, that ABA flying team right there, just to have additional coverage for the Registeel. Doombug playing this kind of in a way where he is setting up the Registeel for success, but it really matters how he's manipulating the shields and the energy at the beginning. I mean, and banking that, I mean, I think he's really punishing Lickitung as well, because Lickitung trying to come in, he's actually just farming the Lickitung and taking a charge move in. And speaking of which, we're going to get into the game five here, and there is a Lickitung from Arrow being met by a Registeel here. You only have one possible answer to it in Poliwrath, and there is the Cresselia here, one of the most punishing Pokemon that you can have against this new pick.
And I think Doombug just said nope, because he just hard called Arrow's line here, having the matchup Registeel into Lickitung and then to have the Cresselia, and it's the Moonblast Cresselia. This is pretty much gonna one-hit KO, so Arrow does decide to Protect Shield. He needs to find some way to get out of the situation, and how many times has he double Protect Shield with this Poliwrath, but against this line, I'm not sure if it matters, because Doon even called the backline Pokemon. He has Whiscash for Skarmory.
Yeah, this is a tough situation. You can double shield if you want, but unfortunately, even for Registeel, leaving a Poliwrath exposed, you're still going to be very susceptible to that Zap Cannon too. So here, it looks like trainers have basically handshaken, and they're going into the two shields, but it's going to be a lot tougher than Arrow can handle, I think, because there are going to be some more surprises down the road. He is going to go, oh, and Doombug actually wins to the Moonblast here, and maybe Arrow didn't press the move there, because I would expect Poliwrath to win the charge attack priority.
Well, I think he was actually trying to swap. I think he was reaching for his timer. I think he was almost up, and he was reaching for that timer to try to get out of there. But as soon as that didn't happen, I think you saw in Arrow's face that this is going to be a real uphill climb, and Doombug is so close to resetting this grand finals bracket and continuing his streak in San Antonio, and he's going to get his Cresselia licked down here, and the Lickitung has a good amount of energy, but that energy goes nowhere into Registeel, and there's a one Protect Shield advantage for Doombug, and he has the Whiscash to match the Skarmory in the back.
Yeah, and this is a tough situation here. I mean, I guess you can accumulate as much lick damage as possible. However, we know the power of Whiscash, how quickly it can outpace to Skulls here, and Skarmory, unfortunately, with that Steel Wing, it is going to generate a lot of energy, but I don't think it has enough power to be able to finish this match. I think both trainers on the screen here, they're kind of bantering amongst each other, but I think they kind of understand what the situation is going to be. Lickitung here going to struggle quite a bit against the Registeel, and it's almost done, because, you know, Doombug's been very, very good at undercharging a Focus Blast just enough to have a threatening move coming into the next matchup here. He is going to actually go for the Excellent here, and he's going to leave, oh, he's going to leave no health, but I think it's pretty elementary at this point. With Skarmory coming in, the one single Zap Cannon is going to leave it in such a bad spot that Whiscash can come in and clean things up.
Can we talk about how Arrow brought a team ABA weak to Registeel when Doombug is running Registeel every single game in this series and almost in the entire tournament? I cannot believe that bold choice from Arrow in this decisive game number five, and it didn't play out, and now Doombug has reset the grand final, so now it is gonna be one more best of five series between Arrow and Doombug, and whoever wins is gonna be your San Antonio regional champion.
And a crazy game five right there. You are right, Butters. I would definitely have. I think the most successful games that Arrow has had is focusing around having, you know, at least some coverage for the Registeel in the back, the Gligar and the Poliwrath together, kind of teaming up to take down the Registeel. Doombug is not going to exclude Registeel from this lineup for sure. So not having a Gligar or not having Gligar and Shadow Poliwrath available was a huge problem right there. And I hope Arrow makes that adjustment here. I think you just have to punish the Registeel. And here we are. We are going to go into the reset bracket here. And now Arrow has the advantage with the Skarmory leading into the Gligar.
He did it again. He ran ABA weak to Registeel again, but it worked out. These crazy calls from Arrow. He was able to play against the ABA flying. And now Doombug doesn't really have an answer for Skarmory. But remember back in the day, Altaria wasn't went that bad versus Skarmory, but this time it has Brave Bird and Steel Wing, so it threw that Brave Bird and then swapped out into the Lickitung.
And now Lickitung, I think it's very happy to absorb all of this energy that Altaria has gotten, and it's gonna be able to lick straight down unless Arrow wants to preserve health, but I don't see why you would want to, just in case there is gonna be a Registeel, and the Altaria actually does not reach the Sky Attack. So, I mean, if you're Doombug here, you're in a tough spot here. Do you come back in with the Gligar knowing that it doesn't do much against the Skarmory, or do you try to get an advantage on the Registeel? It looks like the Registeel has come in instead to soak up all of this energy just to preserve some shields.
This is the smart play, but this is also Doombug's win condition. The Registeel has to absolutely pop off to win this battle, because you'll have to knock out this Lickitung. You'll also have to land Zap Cannons on the Skarmory and the Poliwag. And remember, Arrow does have the alignment here. So even though you knock out this Lickitung, you're going to be facing a 2 Protect Shield Poliwrath. And you know Arrow loves double Protect Shielding Poliwrath.
And here the Lickitung going to take a good amount of health off of this Registeel. We know that Doombug is likely to manipulate this to where he's going to have, you know, 100 energy and then throw the charge move. He's going to throw the Zap Cannon here. This is for sure going to be knocking out the Lickitung, but Poliwrath is going to come straight in, and I'm not sure how Doombug is going to handle this, but is he going to switch immediately into the Gligar to be met? And it looks like, yep, and there is a switch here. Skarmory is going to meet the Gligar, and although Skarmory has taken a little bit of Dragon Breath damage, it still is in a very good spot.
Yeah, and now you're just going for these digs here, but Arrow doesn't have to respect them at all. This is a non-Shadow Gligar. This is single resisted. It's no problem for the Skarmory here, but you will get in danger of getting knocked out from the second dig plus wing attack, so you actually might have to give up Protect Shield. Definitely Doombug wants to give up a Protect Shield here, unless you want to try to lock on down a Skarmory, which is not going to be that easy.
Yeah, and I think Doombug here, I'm not sure if he's going to be happy reinvesting both shields to preserve this Gligar, because I think he might need it, though, because Gligar would be the best possible answer to the Shadow Poliwrath. We'll see here. Arrow's going to be content letting this dig go, and it's going to put the Skarmory in a relatively low position here. I mean, it looks like Doombug is going to go ahead and invest the second shield. Arrow might just be trying to usher the victory in with the Poliwrath instead.
And this isn't over yet. I know it is really in Arrow's favor, but if you can swap on an Icy Wind because your timer is back up, I think that is Doombug's win condition. And Arrow smartly no Protect Shields the Aerial Ace because he knows his lose condition is taking that damage from Zap Cannon. Do you swap on the Icy Wind? He doesn't go for it, and now the Icy Wind will land into the Gligar, and Arrow is poised to take game number one of this series.
Yeah, and what a comeback here. He knows that the best that Doombug can get to before he gets countered down is one charge move here. Doombug not bothering to throw the move, but Arrow will throw a Scald in Celebration here, and Arrow is going to lead the reset bracket 1-0.
And this is reminding me of the past when Onion Frank was just going Leaf Tornado after Leaf Tornado, just making these crazy calls. Arrow keeps playing ABA weak to Registeel. Doombug is bringing Registeel into every game, but it didn't matter in that game number one because he had the proper lead and kept the alignment, so he was able to actually have his only counter aligned on to the Registeel. So now he has a 1-0 lead in this Grand Finals. This is what I'm talking about. Look at this team. There is Registeel in the back for Doombug, and you're just throwing out Skarmory Lickitung lines. It's crazy.
Yeah, and I like this call from Arrow, though. Very risky, but Skarmory is the superior flyer between Altaria, Gligar, and Skarmory, so I think it makes complete sense here that he might be relying on that since Doombug has been favoring the Altaria Registeel core.
And how do you stop that ABA team that's weak to Registeel? So how do you have Registeel in the back, but also beat both of those Pokemon that don't want to see Registeel in the front? And here we are, we're almost locked in. They're kind of speed running through these battles here. They are making these adjustments so quickly in their head right now. Doombug, I don't think he's gonna relent. I think he's gonna keep bringing that Registeel. I'm really curious if Arrow then goes back to what he was doing before. I think he might revert to Shadow Gligar and Poliwrath team, so he has two answers for that Registeel in the back.
Yeah, I really like that idea against Doombug because it looks like Doombug is gonna be stubborn until the very end of this tournament. He might just have Registeel in every single lineup. We are gonna get into game two of the reset bracket, and we have the Shadow Gligar versus the Skeledirge that we haven't seen in a while.
And finally, now he's ABA strong into Registeel, so that was a great adjustment, and you want no part of taking these digs if you are the Skeledirge, but looks like this is going to be the bait on the Aerial Ace, and this is going to be a huge call from Doombug.
Oh, and he lets it go!
He lets it go, and Skeledurs hangs on no problem, and it is at Shadow Ball energy, but he also goes for the bait. So now it's Protect Shielded, so both of these calls have gone Doombug's way early in this game, so I think Skeledurs can take the alignment here.
Yeah, and unfortunately for Arrow here, even if you decided to take the Disarming Voice, it would still deal so much damage, because look at how strong the Skeledurge is. I mean, if you're Arrow, I don't know if you can invest yet another shield, so here comes the second Disarming Voice. We do see the second shield being invested. I mean, this is going to be very tough.
I think he's going to go for the wing attack down. I think he's... Oh, it looks like Doom denies that and swaps into the Wizcatch, but it looked like Arrow wanted alignment at all costs, and of course he does. He's got Carbink in the back, but Doombug has two answers to that Carbink. He has the Registeel, and he has the Wizcatch. Here comes the Poliwrath, though, so that means Registeel will be in the back versus Carbink, but an important factor, there is still health remaining on Shadow Gligar for Arrow.
Yeah, and Poliwrath is going to come in, but Wizcatch has already farmed so much energy. Here is the Mud Bomb here, going to be taking another chunk out of the Shadow Poliwrath here. Arrow thinking about what his options are. Do you need to throw a charge move beforehand, or can you come out with a ton of value here? It looks like he's going to try to get to the counter now, but he knows that Mud Bomb is just a little bit away. And he's forced to throw an Icy Wind. I think Doombug is very happy with all of his energy leaving the Poliwrath here, and Poliwrath, the only real answer for this Registeel, of course, with shields down, this is going to be a tough one, but Skeledurge is going to come back in, and I think the goal of this Pokemon is to absorb even more energy. Oh, actually, it's being shielded.
He has to, because you can't lock on down the Poliwrath. The Poliwrath has a high health pool, so it's going to be impossible to do that. And the attack drop here, you have to bank a move, then you swap, but now you're going to have to take an Icy Wind, maybe, or can you get the lock on down first? Oh. But no, Arrow swapped out into the Gligar, but are you going to outpace the Gligar into a charge attack? This might be the win for Doombug, because if he can knock out this Shadow Gligar, it's going to be Registeel versus that Carbink in the back line.
And we do see the focus take things out.
Oh,
came in and got the Scald off. Are we going to see the attack drop?
He needs the attack drop, but Doombug has the Skeledurge and no health. He can swap to it later. No attack drop, but at this point...
But here's the thing. Carbink is tanky enough to survive some of these charge moves here. I mean, I think you have to go for Zapdos, and if you're Doombug, is there going to be a debuff? I don't think Rock Slide is enough. I think you have to go... I think you might have to go for a double Rock
no
Slide.
No debuff! No way! And I did not think that Poliwrath would get to
going
that.
Going for the Moonblast!
And there it is! This is the Moonblast!
Is this enough for Carbink? It is a stab move, and Moonblast is quite good here. Do we see it? It is not enough!
He needs to get to this Focus Blast. Does he have the Disarming Voice banked? I think he has it.
I think he has it.
If he has the Disarming Voice banked, I think it will be enough to knock
out the
Carbink.
Right now. Let's see if he has it. He does
have
Disarming Voice.
Combo play into Disarming Voice. There is so much
help. Can Carbink survive this, because it's a non-stab move?
And he hangs on.
It's going to lock down. Takes it instead.
What an epic end to that battle. It doesn't get closer than that in Pokemon Go PvP. This is the best of the best.
What an ending right there. You have Carbink's Rock Throw going through on the Disarming Voice, taking out the Skeledurge, but Lock On is an even faster move than Rock Throw.
Wow. Registeel has been the MVP for Doombug. Can we see the end of that game? Can we slow that down at some point? Actually, this was crucial, though. Because Doombug outpaced the Gligar, this was Arrow's best win condition, was to get a charge attack on that Gligar. And this was crazy.
Yeah,
there's nothing left on this Poliwrath, and this Poliwrath gets to the Scald to put Registeel close to in range of that Moonblast. And this is the point where it is so close. It is literally a game of inches here. There's almost nothing left. Combo move. Here comes
the
Disarming Voice.
It's so close here. You can see the Rock Throw going through on Arrow's side, and the Disarming Voice leaves it with a sliver of health here. I mean, I don't know if that Zap Cannon debuff is going to affect things. I don't think it did, Butters, because it does leave Carbink at a small sliver no matter what, and the Registeel ends with...
It was at one health.
Yeah,
you know how I know? Because it got knocked out by Lock-On, so it was guaranteed at one health there. And here comes the lead. It is the Poliwrath calling the lead from the Registeel. They're back in it. It's tied 1-1, but this time, the alignment is not in Doombug's favor, and Arrow has fantastic alignment here. He has the Skarmory for this Cresselia, and then, of course, he has that Poliwrath for the Registeel, and ABA strong to the Registeel, but
Doombug is unrelenting, bringing it every battle.
Yeah, and Arrow this time had a great response to it. Like we mentioned before, the Gligar and Shadow Poliwrath combo is adequate protection against this Registeel. It just really depends on how Arrow wants to play this out. But in this situation, great matchup here. These Steel Wings are going to start chunking the Cresselia here, and Arrow is in a pretty good spot.
And you have a way to soak this energy. You can go for some sort of lock on down, but you just can't get this Skarmory low enough to secure that lock on down. Here is an undercharge here. I don't know if that was a great undercharge, because unless Arrow is gonna pivot, which I don't think he wants to do, now you can give the Registeel an opportunity to lock on down the Skarmory.
Yeah, I think Arrow might be thinking about pivoting though, because
oh, he is gonna pivot.
Yeah.
Because he has both of his answers are in the back still.
So
yeah,
now
yeah.
you have Gligar versus Gligar with an energy advantage. I mean, Doombug here, I saw this, maybe the sly smile from him. I think he understands how this is going to effectively play out here, because Arrow is effectively coming to a Gligar versus Gligar fight, but he has an extra sky attack that's in his back pocket.
Yeah, that was a great play by Arrow. I'm so used to him being ABA weak to Registeel. He's ABA strong to Registeel. So he can obviously pivot out of Skarmory, because both of his Pokemon in the back are so strong against that Registeel. So that was a great undercharge to maximize energy on that Skarmory to get the Steel Wing down, and Doombug is just in so much trouble as he takes the Aerial Ace from that Shadow Gligar. All he has left is that Registeel. How many times have we said that in this tournament? But this time is one of the times I don't think it's gonna be enough. I actually know it's not gonna be enough.
Yeah, and here with Doombug, he's going to be able to wing attack down Arrow's Gligar, but Skarmory is going to come in and clean that up very quickly. It's going to threaten with the Brave Bird. At this point, Butters, it's a health game, and unfortunately for Registeel, you do need three charge moves, but the damage is going to be coming so fast from the Poliwrath here, and right now, these counters are going to start adding up. It is a non-shadow Poliwrath, but as you can see here, from a charge move pacing perspective, it does not even matter, because you're going to use both Protect Shields here. Arrow even gets to the Scald first. I don't think the debuff is going to matter a lot here, but oh, and Doombug is going to go ahead and elect to take it. I think he understands how this is going to play out.
Yeah, it's over. So Doombug lets that go, but then throws a Zap Cannon just to see, hey, I let one go. Arrow, you let one go too, all right? But Arrow didn't oblige.
Still gets the debuff.
He didn't oblige, and now Arrow is one victory away from becoming the San Antonio regional champion. This is his home state of Texas, and this would be his first ever regional championship.
Yeah, and this is gonna be huge for Arrow here, because is he gonna go with old reliable, almost having the Poliwrath and the Gligar core? And then for Doombug here, you've played Registeel. I mean, this is potentially the ninth game that you played Registeel. Is it finally time to pivot away and not be punished by this pick? This is going to be really huge for both trainers here. I mean, if Doombug elects to stay with the Registeel, I hope he has a good plan for the Shadow or for the Poliwrath and Gligar combination, because so far this has given him the most trouble.
This has been Arrow's dream for so long. Since 2022, NAIC, Baltimore, Salt Lake City, Arlington, Peoria, oh. World, North American International Championships again, Hartford, Fort Wayne, Charlotte, Knoxville,
and
Orlando,
and he is one game away from being the
champion.
But here's the thing, we see the Whiscash come out from Doombug, and the Poliwrath is here to answer it. If the Poliwrath gets too low, you're still going to have that single backline matchup that we don't want to have.
It's not over, because Doombug has Registeel. And once again, Arrow, when it matters, he is running the ABA weak to Registeel. So Registeel in the back,
oh,
in the attack drop
here. Ball
but
here.
We saw this before, the double Mud Bomb is still enough. Even though the attack drop was secured, this Mud Bomb plus the next Mud Bomb will force a Protect Shield out of Arrow if he wants to maintain alignment. But what does he care about alignment, right?
Yeah.
He's double weak to Registeel, and he knows there's Registeel in the back.
I wonder if Arrow is starting to sense that there might be a Registeel here, because if he does, it's probably a good time to use a Protect Shield here and potentially pivot out. You need this damage. He does. He does sense something is wrong. He's going to use a Protect Shield here and threaten the counter down. So my guess is that when Altaria comes in, he's going to use the Lickitung and potentially pivot out of here. Is he going to be able to reach a move before Whiscash gets to a Mud Bomb? He is not. And now he's in a very, very tough spot here, because you brought in the Poliwrath to answer the Whiscash, and now you might lose a alignment because of it.
And there is the counter down from the Poliwrath. You have the alignment, but for what? At least you might pick up the protection shield. You might get it back. And no, actually, Doombug does not take the bait. He wants to keep that protect shield for the Registeel. It's going to be Lickitung pivoting in here. And is it going to be met by the Registeel? This is a debuffed Altaria. Maybe he's going to try to swap on the Body Slam. No, and yes,
oh,
he does
swap.
He makes a catch on that Body Slam. And now this sets up Doombug for getting the Focus Blast and Locked On down. And it was crucial that he got that Dragon Breath damage on that Lickitung.
And this is going to be a very, very close one, Butters, because here's the thing. Carbink does not care about Altaria in any possible way. However, you may end up relying on this Carbink to deal any semblance of damage because you have the Poliwrath here. You might get a few counters in before the charge move comes out, but if Doombug plays this correctly, you are right, Butters. He is going to lock on down this Lickitung and threaten charge moves. And let's see what happens here. He leaves Lickitung with an adequate amount of energy. I think this is almost the perfect lock on down amount here. We're gonna have another Body Slam, but Poliwrath may not have too much of an impact here. It might come down to how much damage will Rock Thrower do against a Steel type.
I think you're right about Poliwrath. I think Poliwrath still has a chance to do really well here.
I think you have to peekaboo.
I think you come in with Carbink, you soak this, and this is Carbink coming in soaking it, maybe get the debuff, and then you can swap out of it. But the problem is, if you then swap, so will Doombug, and Doombug will swap, and no, he actually made the catch.
What?
No.
He swapped immediately. Okay, took, this is okay.
He took the Zap Cannon, and then he swapped. There was the counter swap by Doombug, and you have to throw the Moonblast here because the Sky Attack is obviously resisted, and like you mentioned, Carbink doesn't really care about anything from Altaria. Oh my
goodness.
Oh, he gets
attacked. This might actually work out. You get a little bit more farm here. Does a debuff Rock Slide do anything to this Registeel? I think we're about to find out here. I don't think it's going to be enough.
We saw a full-powered Moonblast do nothing to a Registeel. Now the attack is dropped. I don't think this Carbink has any chance. And Doombug has Grand Finals 2-2.
And Butters, we have a game 10 between these two trainers here. And it looks like the two styles, I mean, Arrow's reluctance to play any kind of double counter to Registeel, but Doombug's persistence in playing Registeel. Is Arrow going to bring an ABA weak to Registeel team?
When it has mattered most, he has brought an ABA weak to Registeel team, but he has won games when he's brought the ABA strong to Registeel team. I think he's gonna bring two possible counters for the Registeel or two possible Pokemon. And this, the end game here, it was just so tough. You thought maybe Poliwrath had a chance at that low health if you could align it with that Registeel to get some counters in. But the situation that we'll have in the end, it all came down to the Registeel had too much energy, and that is not a high chance of that happening. And I think we're actually in the battle. This is game number 5. Whoever wins this will be the San Antonio Regional Champion. And now this is a swap into Poliwrath, but it's met by the Gligar, and Gligar does get to the Aerial Ace first, and here comes the instant Protect Shield, a classic strategy from Arrow to Protect Shield Poliwrath.
And here we are. I think it's gonna be a double, I think you're right, Butters, a two shield situation here. Poliwrath gonna be firing out these Icy Winds as much as possible, but as you can see from Doombug, great adjustments here. There's nothing weak to Carbink on his side.
And Registeel, of course, is in the back, but now you have the Charjabug in the back instead of the Lickitung. So Arrow finally sits that Lickitung in this crucial game number 5. Can this Aerial Ace knockout? It's not enough. Now Poliwrath is going to get to the Icy Wind. So I actually don't know if this Icy Wind is enough, but it gets Protect Shielded anyway.
Yeah, and we're not going to find out because of the Protect Shield here. And there is going to be a Protect Shield advantage, which does open the window a little bit for Arrow, because as we discussed, Butters, I mean, Charjabug is gonna take resisted damage on both charge moves.
How do you deal with Whiscash? Whiscash is in the back, and it is gonna be the Whiscash. And I think I saw Arrow, I read his lips, he said, good game. It's not necessarily over, but calling the backline with this Whiscash into the backline of Carbink, Charjabug, Doombug has the clear advantage here, and I think he is just moments away from securing his championship. He just needs to play cleanly throughout the battle.
There's not enough time and not enough energy that Charjabug can generate to get through all this, because it really does have to answer all of these Pokemon here. And even this X-Scissor, I think, is gonna be neutral. It's not gonna be enough to KO. You have to literally Volt Switch this down, but Doombug is already aware of this. This Scald will be getting through the shield here. I think Arrow's going to let this one go, and I think Doombug is going to be securing victory.
And there goes the Charger Bug, and this Whiscash is still around. This has been one of the surprises here in San Antonio. Doombug has ran a lot of Whiscash to win this tournament, and he is just moments away. The Scald, and for good effect,
there
it gets the attack drop. And for better effect, here's the Registeel.
And the tried and true Pokemon from Doombug here, I would say it is, you know, I don't want to discount the Skeledirge, but Registeel has been Doombug's signature Pokemon for this event here. He is going to be able to use the Zap Cannon to finish things off for maybe a little bit longer, but the double attack fall here is going to make sure that he secures the victory. Both, you know, and we have Doombug here, all smiles here, finishing on off Arrow with the lock on down. And Doombug is going to be your San Antonio regional champion.
And Doombug has now won two straight Texas regionals in Arlington last season, and now in San Antonio. He lost his first match of the tournament, and he climbed all the way back to the grand finals, reset the grand finals, and won a best of five versus Arrow to become your grand champion. This was Doombug's event.